Still coming rampant, misbehaving, misbehaving. Still coming anti up, rebelling with my ravers. Still don't give a f- about who be the latest. Can't be locked up in them cages. Start living up. So what the f*** you think of days?
But hey, what about the
so I stepped on stage, they were like, see the crowd going, eh? They were like, so I stepped on stage, they were like,
ooh yeah.
See the crowd going, eh? They were like,
ooh yeah. Ooh yeah.
I can get it gone in a blink. We can make a from the.
On a gorgeous southern afternoon, EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to Atlanta, Georgia, and inside Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Today, after a topsy-turvy opening.
Eating up wins for breakfast, I can tell you what it tastes like. Wake up and I see red and I still don't got no brake lights. Yeah, feeling super fly. I look in the mirror, see ambition in my eyes. Got more than one formula, they love the way I drive. Yeah, I've been the prize, there's no need to be surprised. Baby, I'm a go-getter, go-getter. Yeah, you better go figure, go figure. Baby, I'm a go-getter, go-getter. Yeah, you better go figure, go figure.
Try and get a big stack in my bag. Boy, you know I'm getting to it, it's like that. Try and get a big stack in my bag. Yeah, you know I'm getting to it, it's like that, like that.
Hey, never feeling the pressure, please not at all. I walk in when it's crunch time, leaves in the fall. Woman on me, only hear my name on a roll call. It's like there is no ground beneath my feet, I got no flaws. Still humble, but just don't get it confused. You know who I am, there's no need to introduce. I am one of one, they can't stand it, but it's true. Sicker than the average, ain't no challenge that's immune. Baby, I'm a go-getter, go-getter. Yeah, you better go figure, go figure. Baby, I'm a go-getter, go-getter. Yeah, you better go figure, go figure.
Try and get a big stack in my bag. Boy, well, you know I'm getting to it, it's like that. Try and get a big stack in my bag. Yeah, you know I'm getting to it, it's like that, big stack, big stack in my bag.
It is a Chamber of Commerce afternoon here in the Peach State of Georgia. We've got the roof open, wide open, and we are ready for football at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Today, after a topsy-turvy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here, as it'll be the Green Bay Packers taking on the Atlanta Falcons. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. In motion, the tight end. Here's Love looking to pass on the first play. Oh, the first play of the game going to be intercepted. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now the first running back taken back in April, the former Longhorn, Bijan Robinson. That is out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. That burst good for 20 and a first down. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're open. And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. He couldn't get rid of it. He winds up losing a yard. It's second down. And it it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try and take you out of that.
This will be caught at about the six. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it's third and four now. On third down, Robinson. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Bijan Robinson, his second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Falcons take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And the interception on that opening drive winds up leading to the touchdown, so now it's kind of time to start over.
Yeah, it certainly is, and his first throw of the game. But I like the way his guys rallied around him. Oftentimes, the quarterback is the leader, right? He tells everyone what to do. In this case, I noticed his linemen around him kind of patting him, saying, "Let's go, big boy. You're still our leader."
He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
Love, he's going to change the play here. A guy coming off a career high in rushing yards last year. Here's Aaron Jones. And he showed off the athletic juke. Good little gain there. Not a whole lot of real estate, but a nice carry. Ritter with it after the play fake. They'll roll him out right. That's brought in downfield by London. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
Well, as a coach, you absolutely love seeing your offense find their rhythm early. That's exactly what we've seen so far. They had a touchdown on their opening drive, and now they connect here for another nice gain for a first down. This offense is moving the ball well, exactly as he drew it up in practice.
On first and 10, it's Robinson. And he stopped immediately there. Brought down that time by Quay Walker.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Ritter from the gun. This will be caught just inside the 10. And the Falcons are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Robinson is going to go backwards. He'll lose yardage back to the 5. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
An awful lot of congestion in the middle third of the field, but how about our defensive tackle right there? He just held the line. He provided some push and smacked the ball carrier down for a loss.
One of only two rookies to top 1,000 yards on the ground last year. Here's Tyler Algier. Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4-down territory.
A little antsy on the left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they got the guy in the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And let's face it, he is so amped up, wanting to get a good get off on the snap, jump too quickly.
The ball placed just outside of the end zone as they come up again on another third and goal. Ritter going to sneak it. And I don't think he got there. No, they stop him right where it all started. Only a few inches needed on the sneak. He didn't get it, and now it's fourth down.
Brandon, third and goal from the one, and they go quarterback sneak, and they expected a surge up front. The surge came from the defense.
Yeah, it looked like there was no surprise defensively. They were ready.
Yeah, totally stacked it up, unable to get it on third down.
They get the completion but cannot push forward into the end zone. And the Packer defense stands tall down by the goal line. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. Let's see if they can do better here on this drive. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
Come on, set. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. His end zone. Love. This one swung out here to Jones. And they'll mark him down right around the 9, just shy of the 10. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Third and two. Love with it. He'll find Jones again. Complete. And this is not going to be enough. Was in search of 2 yards and only got halfway there. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on 4th and 1 yard. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And it's going to be batted down. And we'll go the other way with the football. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. Ritter, he wants to change the play here. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. That ball is caught. It's London for the Atlanta touchdown. Touchdown of the new season, and the Falcons are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Crew able to connect on the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. Following the touchdown, here's Crew to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. The Ruggs throw brought in by Watson. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. It needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
It's another first down on what will be a gain of 21 yards. If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes it's just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
Now a first down carry by Jones. Down the sideline he goes. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones, 37 yards. And the Packers have got it back to within a score. Carlson's extra point up and good. And that'll make our score 14-7. So after the made field goal, here's Carlson to send it away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field. Second and six, just inside the 30. Ritter. This pass is caught by London. He's exceeded his receiving yards from a week ago, and we're still in the first half. It's a first down. Ritter to throw it. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. The Falcons had 0-1 in the year following the loss in the opener. And they were given a gift to two straight home games to start the campaign. Dropped one of them already. You have to figure a split of these two probably imperative.
And they did talk about that with us prior to the game, about how important it is to start the season 1-1, especially with two games at home. Because if you go 0-2, hard to make those up on the road as the season progresses.
Now the throw left sideline here is complete. He's got room at the 40. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 23. Ritter headed right off the option. And holding it, maybe the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. Big Kenny Clark that time pushing upfield to make the tackle for loss. And not a lot of success to be found there.
Oh, you got that right, partner, because if you're trying to make guys miss about 10 yards or so downfield, that's a pretty good play. But if you've got to do it in your own backfield, I consider that a problem. That doesn't work too well.
And he's got the speedster Goodwin. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. From the 2 now, second and goal. Flushed. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Desmond Ritter with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Falcons have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And it's now 21-7. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Jordan Love ready on first down here. Pass caught. It's Romeo Dobbs. Into space at the 45. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. The shotgun. It's Love. Completes it again to Dobbs. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Right back to him for 10 more and a first.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise, and start to put together some drives.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try to pick up another first down.
secondary now for the Falcons on third down. In motion goes the tight end. On third down, here's Jones. And a short gain down to about the 33. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try to fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
And they'll begin by running the option. And he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line.
Rashawn Gary that time through the line and getting the tackle for loss.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. On play action, here's Ritter. Open man is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. His first catch, good for 16 and a first.
Even in only 10 games, seeing Pitts drop from 1,000 to under 400 yards receiving was tough last season. And he has only 3 total touchdowns in his first 2 years. Still one of the most athletic tight ends in the league. I expect last season to be the anomaly.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Back to throw, Ritter. And he fires one incomplete.
Let's phrase this delicately, okay? Might have had a better option instead of throwing the football into double coverage.
He was blanketed. I was surprised that he went his direction.
Yeah, should have thought maybe about the check down. Take the completion, keep moving.
Stick it with a passing game. Here's Ritter again. Packer pressure, and down he goes. Preston Smith comes in for the sack. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. On fourth down, Bradley Pinion on to punt for the Falcons. Fielded just inside the 20. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A great return there of 22 yards. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them 3. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker to nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it, and he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well.
Well, the pressure gets to Love, and he'll go down. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. This one into the hands of the rookie Luke Musgrave. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down.
I
like the boldness of that play call from the offensive coordinator, because he wasn't daunted even by the double coverage he expected to draw to the tight end. The result, a huge gain and a major shot of confidence for everyone on the offense. Love to throw for it on fourth. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Reed. And he is going to have a Packers first down. They go for it on fourth and two, and it's a gain of six. Love now. Towards the middle and caught by Musgrove. A good-looking drive for the Packers so far. It's a first down. The clock rolls as the Packers look to hurry things up. And they'll send the tight end in motion. Play action this time with Love. And he just throws this one away. That was a bit strange, and here comes the flag. Yeah, he hadn't gotten far enough away from the pocket to throw that football away, and that draws the flag.
Yeah, the old tackle box, right? Get outside of each tackle, and then you can go ahead and throw it away, and you're in good shape. Right. But if you're back there in the pocket, you got to make sure of what you're doing.
Going back to Love. A short throw to Musgrove. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. On third down, Love. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one, they were just unable to complete the pass.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle, and that'll make this an 8-point game. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And with an 8-point lead, probably not too much of an impetus to try and do too much here. And that is incomplete. Now the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
Ridder now on second down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Goodwin. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. A game there of 30 big ones.
Well, you don't have to be a genius to watch this game and figure out they've had plenty of success moving the football here in the first half. We've seen exhibits A, B, C, and right on down the line, haven't we?
Yeah, we just saw exhibit Z right there. Things looking much rosier for them here in week two. They work with the lead as they've got it first and 10. That's caught inside the 20. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
Here we go.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Looking to throw once more. Here's Ridder. For the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, it hasn't been a banner first half for the defense trying to cover him today, but they'll take that one right there, helping force that incompletion.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. Koo knocks this one through the post, and the lead now 11, 24-13. So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock and pretty much drained everything before into the half.
So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we
find
our man
Jonathan Coachman.
We're just
about set to get back to it. Both teams making their final adjustments. And we'll head back to Atlanta and rejoin Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thank you very much. As we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember in that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
Yeah, they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
On second down, another shot for Robinson. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 44 here. 43 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. They'll run again here with Robinson. And this will be a Falcons 1st down as good running gets him to about the 44.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
Hand off to Robinson out of the shotgun. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Here's Ritter. Throws to his man on the out route. It's complete. That's Robinson. On the move past the 40. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 32-yard line. The catch and run good for 24 yards. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
And now defensively, you have to look at this like the game's on the line. It's just the third quarter, but another touchdown given up here could really spell an end to their chances. So they need to toughen up and keep them out of the end zone.
2nd and goal from inside the 5. Ritter fires quickly out wide. Touchdown! Marquise Goodwin from 4 yards out. And the Falcons take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Koo able to connect on the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. They'll try and get the running game going with Jones. Gets past one man. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. 1st down. 1st down, Packers. Out to the left here to Reed. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. And they get 17 more on that one and another 1st down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
11 more on that one and another first down.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find answers, and they've got to find them quick.
Now a throw for the left sideline, and he's got it. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy. Nice pickup.
And the Packers are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves him all the way down to the one.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Jones will score. Touchdown, Packers. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
Well, Packer offense and Jordan Love staying out there, so they're going to try to go for two. They'll look to throw. And he's got it for the two-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further. So now Carlson, after the touchdown, called on to send this one away. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. This now a 10-point game, so things tightening a little bit after that last score. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Second down and a run by Robinson. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 75 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
No surprise, Robinson is looking like one of the best running back prospects we've seen in a long time. He became the face of the Atlanta football team the second he was drafted, and he should be ripping off big runs for them for years to come.
Back to Robinson now on first down. And a good burst there gets him seven up to midfield.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
A give to Robinson on the option. They find some open field here. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 15 yards, first down, Atlanta.
And we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Throw left side, there's London. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number three. Three quarters in the books. And we'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Come on, back.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Out of the gun, they give to Robinson.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Preston Smith there on the stop. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going,
touchdown Falcons! Julio Jones, his second touchdown on the season, and the Falcons are an extra point away from making this a three-score game. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, that's a good way of pointing things out, because now it's not a total loss, because as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
To throw now, here's Love. And that one incomplete, but now a penalty flag coming in late. That might be P.I.
So pass interference, the call, is so tough as a defender, I'd imagine, to time that up perfectly.
It certainly is difficult to get it exactly right, because sometimes you're looking at getting there fractions of seconds too early. That one looked a little more obvious. Always a tough penalty to officiate. Just ask the basketball refs when they have to officiate block and charge.
After the penalty, it's Jones. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 66 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the first three quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, they want to ride him down the stretch. He should have fresh legs.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Well, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down.
Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first three quarters, and this deficit going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth, but a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where, as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution. Even though the scoreboard is going against you, you want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
Flushed out right. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
I do think it's fair to say that they were caught off guard a little bit. We decided not to throw it on first down. But give them credit, they recovered in time to deny him the first down yardage. But it's only 2nd and short, so that run is still likely to lead to a new set of downs.
And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws. That's good power football on first and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there, but that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
Here's Love. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. And it's a Packers first touchdown. Aaron Jones, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Packers have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. Carlson's extra point up and good. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. Carlson back out there now to send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. Oh, good looking return set up here. He's past the 30. He will score. Touchdown, Falcons. It's been a back and forth game. A lot of points on the board, and that return right there kind of indicative of how this thing's gone.
Yeah, you've seen both teams go at it, and as you just pointed out, both of them have found the end zone. But just like in boxing, you know the blow that hurts the most? The one you didn't see coming. And that often is the case when it comes in special teams.
Crew able to connect on the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around.
First down, Packers.
No, Love wants to shift things around. They go play action here on first down. He finds his man complete. It's Reed. 11 yards for number 11. A 3-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But if they trim that lead down to just 2 scores, that's still a benefit to this squad.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Love going to give this one to Jones. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. It's a gain of 12, and the Packers have the first.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
This one swung out here to Jones. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. So give him the yardage on the completion and also tack on 15 more.
If you get that hand up there, you've got to let go immediately or just not close the hand at all. He didn't, gave it a tug, and that was easy for the officials to see.
Steps away to his left. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's 2nd down. Love from the gun. In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12. Brady Jarrett making his presence felt. He gets the sack.
Remember, throughout my career here, defensive coach would always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. Well, they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed.
Come on, sack.
Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10. Now Love. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. It's a loss of 10 on the sack, and it leads to 4th.
Well, these guys want to do something positive as this game approaches its end, but after giving up back-to-back sacks, it's really been more indicative of how the game has gone for them.
No choice but to go. Here's fourth down now. Desperation time here. Love on fourth down. Got Dobbs over the middle. Moving inside the 20. And he's not able to get away. He is stopped well, well short of a first down. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. CD, this is the ideal situation, the fourth quarter. You come out here late, not much time on the clock, with a comfortable lead, and put the first mistake for him in the ball game as it's intercepted. Rasul Douglas picks it. Following the interception, Love, buying time to his left. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Partner, the good ones have a clock running in their head, okay, because it says something like this. I've got this many seconds to find a target. After that, I have to tuck it and try and get some yardage on this first down snap. He doesn't just get some yards, though. He gets a big gain, and they'll come right back with another first and 10.
Here we go. Here we go.
Jordan Love ready on first down here. That's going to be caught. Touchdown. Luke Musgrave, 28 yards. And the Packers take the interception on defense and convert it into 6 points. Love. And they're going to get the two-point conversion, caught in the end zone, and that cuts the lead a bit further. So time definitely not in their favor, down two scores, but they'll try the onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
Play action is supposed to be used to slow down pressure, slow down blitzes. In this case, though, if it takes a little too long to develop, you got people right in your face.
And lucky just to get rid of the ball with the arm going forward. Could have been a fumble. Now it looks like he'll throw here. It's caught at the 10. Inside the 10, marking down at the 9. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
And if it wasn't over before, it is now. Looking for that one final first down. They got it and then some. And if they play things right from here on out, that should just about assure them a victory.
Escaping the pressure right. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. And the Packers are going to take over at their own 11-yard line.
Here we go.
Oh, wait, hold everything. A timeout has been called. Seemingly silly with 1 second remaining in this game.
Get ready.
Get And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. One last shot now for Love. Throw caught by Musgrave. A solid stiff arm. Well, this was a fun one today if you like points. A lot of them went on the board.